Welcome to Next Level Intel. This week we've been exploring how to use a data table within Microsoft Excel, and we really hope you're enjoying this series. Today we're going to expand on that and show you how to sort and filter your data so that you can better organize and present it. Let's get started. So we have our data table here that we've been working on this week. We've added some conditional formatting to signify when we have duplicate entries in the type column, which we will discuss in a later video. So the first thing that you notice is that there are arrows on the headers up here. These arrows are what you can click on to help you sort and filter your data. When you click on the arrow, you notice that it provides you a lot of sort and filter options. So the first one we're going to show you is how to sort. There are three different ways that you can sort. You can sort from A to Z, which is alphabetically. You can also sort from Z to A, which is backwards. And when you're dealing with numbers, you can sort from smallest to largest and also largest to smallest. Now over in the type section, you see that we have different colors. So when you click on that arrow, you can sort by color. And you can sort the color to where that shows first. So all of our duplicates are first and then our singles are below. Then to filter. Now we are going to filter our data. As you see down here, we have check marks. The first thing you want to do is uncheck the select all, and then you can click on the name that you're looking for. So I'm going to click on Cabela and hit OK. We had three entries with that last name. When you are dealing with long lists of data, this filtering option allows to speed up the process. So now we're going to go down and hit the select all, and it selects them all again. So this time we're going to type a certain name out. So we're going to type the name in here because when you get to a certain level or limit within Microsoft Excel as far as data, it's not able to list every single entry. So you can also type what you're searching for. So if we're searching for Smith, we can type Smith and it's right there for us to click and then hit OK. And we see that there were four Smith entries in our data. So you can also go up here to the filter and say we're looking for Arch. You can type Arch and we want to add it to our Smith data. We're going to go here and click and then we're going to hit OK. So now we have Arch and Smith together. The next option to filter is the text option. And you can go into text filters, hit contains, the word Smith. And then they give you two options that we will go over in just one moment. And so you want to click on this drop down and hit contains again. And you're looking for transactions that also contain the word Arch. Now the two options that they give you is if you are looking for a single cell to contain both Smith and Arch, then you would hit and. Now we know that we do not have a customer name that is named Smith and Arch within that cell. So we are going to click or because we are looking for all transactions that contain either Smith or Arch. And now we have our transactional history. Now the last filter that we're going to show is that you can also filter by color. So you can go into the type and filter by color, and you click the color that you're wanting to filter by. And now we see that these are the transactions that Smith or Arch have that contain the fill color red. So now you know how to sort and filter your data within Microsoft Excel in a data table. And we just want to say thank you for the likes, the shares, and the comments on this mini series. We really hope that you're enjoying it. And we welcome you to be a part of our tribe and join us on this journey to enhance online education. Don't wait to be a beta tester in October. We need beta testers right now. This is a place where constructive criticism is welcomed so we can serve you best. From Next Level Intel, thank you, happy learning, and God bless.